Welcome to another After Effects tutorial. In this tutorial I'm going to teach you how to create frame-by-frame animation with sequence of images. Also you'll learn how to use time stretching and time reversing. Let's get started. Create new composition. I'm going to change background to white for better visibility. Keep frame rate 30 or 60. My animation is simple, so I'm keeping duration to 2 seconds. Now drop the sequence of images to the project panel. Bring all the images to the timeline. As you see, all images are overlapped and only first frame is visible throughout. Let's make animation out of these images. On the top side of the timeline panel, you'll see the time scale shown over here. As you see, F is written, this means frame. You can stretch the timeline for better editing. We have only 4 image sequence for animation. So I'm keeping each image duration of 5 frame. This means each image lasts for 5 frame duration. Now one important step, make sure the image sequence you dropped in timeline is properly arranged. In my case it's suffix numbers. This will help in making animation properly. Otherwise animation will be messed up. Select the first image, cut the image at 5th frame. You can use Shift-D for that. Delete the extra frame. Select the second image and make sure you are at 5th frame and again press Shift-D. Delete the extra one. Do this for the rest of the images. Now you see the animation. If it is too slow or fast, or you want to repeat the animation, you have to pre-compose all the frames. To do, select all the images, right-click and select pre-compose. You can name it or leave it. Tick this button to move all files to the composition. Now you can make any changes to this composition and whole animation will be affected. Let's trim out the extra portion of animation. You can multiply composition to repeat animation for longer period. Pre-compose all the file again. Call it with a different name. The position of the bird is at center. Let's make the bird fly from left to right and go backward as you've seen at the beginning of this video. To do so, expand the composition by clicking this icon. As you see, many transform options are there to sizing and positioning the objects in that composition. Drag the layer to the left side till the bird is not visible. As only position is moved, we can add the keyframe at this point. Make sure you are at the first frame. Timeline is very important as it decides the animation timing. Go to last frame and drag the layer to the center. As the auto keyframe is on, you see a keyframe is added here. Press spacebar to see the animation. To make animation smooth, select all the keyframes and right-click. In keyframe assistance, select Easy Ease. See the changes. If the animation is too slow or fast, you can make changes in time section. Just right-click on the composition and go to time. Here you'll find time stretch option. Click on it. Here you can edit the duration of the animation. You can make changes if you need. I'll change the duration to 50%. This makes my animation last for a second. For another second, let's make bird fly back to the original position. To animate other half, duplicate the layer and drag till the end of the first layer. Go to Layer tab, in Transform menu, select Flip Horizontal. As you see, bird is moving backward and we need bird fly from right to left. To fix this, right-click on the layer. Go to Time, select Time Reverse Layer. This will reverse the animation. Now, our animation is completed. In this tutorial, you learned how to make frame-by-frame animation and how time stretching and time reversal works. In the next video, we are going to create a beautiful Twitter lower third animation using this. Also, I'll explain the concept of masking and we do text animations as well. Hope you enjoyed learning. Please hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more quick tutorials. Also comment if you stuck anywhere. See you in the next video.